He loved us. He cared for us. He was concerned about us. To sum it up, He was keen over us. You may be saying, on what basis do I speak about Him or about how He felt, even though no one knows what was in His heart? On what basis am I saying He loved us, He was concerned about us, He was keen over us? On what basis? I have very strong evidence to support my claim. This evidence is the testimony of Allah Himself in the Quran. If you read Surah At-Tawbah, at the end of the surah, Allah says the following: لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. There has come unto you a messenger from amongst yourselves. You know him. You know him. عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ. It grieves him that you should face any difficulty. It makes him sad that you should encounter any problems or obstacles. حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. He is keen over you. He is anxious over you. He is concerned about you. بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. To the believers, He was full of mercy and kindness. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who said that about Him? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He described Him in this fashion: keen over us. In another description in the Quran, in Surah Al-Jumu'ah, Allah said, هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. It is He, Allah, who sent among the illiterate ones a messenger from amongst them. What does He do? يعلمهم يزكيهم. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يتلو عليهم آياته. He recites unto us the verses of Allah. And then He purifies us from shirk and evil character and bad conduct. وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. And He taught us the book and the sunnah. Al-Hikmah, according to Imam Shafi and others, is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even though prior to that we were in manifest error. Even though prior to that we were in manifest error. So this is again another description by Allah concerning the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These two verses have been reinforced with a narration. The narration where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَدَدْتُ لَوْ أَنِّي لَقِيتُ إِخْوَانِي قَالَ أَصْحَابُهُ أَوَلَيْسَ نَحْنُ إِخْوَانَكَ قَالَ أَنْتُمْ أَصْحَابِي وَلَكِنْ إِخْوَانِي هُمُ الَّذِينَ وَلَكِنْ إِخْوَانِي الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِي وَلَمْ يَرَوْنِي. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in an authentic narration, I wish I could see my brothers. I wish I could see my brothers. The Sahaba said, are we not your brothers, O Messenger of Allah? He said, no, you are my companions. My brothers are those who believed in me but have not seen me. Who is he speaking about? You and I. He wished he had what? Seen us. He was anxious, looking forward to meet one of us. And what would we do if we ever met with him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And what would we do when we meet him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of judgment, coming looking like someone other than him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, coming having lived the life that opposed him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, coming having divorced his sunnah in every way, shape or form? But we want all the goodness on that day. He was keen over those people. But who are these people in particular? Not everyone. Not every Tom, Dick and Harry is included in these. It is a selected few. Those who understand his status and follow the teachings accordingly. This was the reality of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.